man, baby Angel, this is sweet. I love these nights. We just chill out, sleep over, in our jammies, watching movies.
I so know. Cool. It's like a big girly sleepover, except you're not a girl.
You just call me a girl. But anyway, that last movie was so cool. It was all about investigation and crime and all stuff. But the boring ads are on now. But I wonder what's next.
Well, I don't know. Let's just flick through the channels. Ooh. What's that?
Uh-oh, okay, hold on. It looks like breaking news.
Oh, weird.
Breaking news here at ABC Studios. It seems the homecoming show for the amazing Jacksons has been tarnished in tragedy. The boy band were seen exiting the Oscars theater, and suddenly they were kidnapped. This seems like it's a job for the Mindvengers. I'm going to pass you to my correspondent live at the scene. It's Amy Adams.
Yes,
Amy, take
Marty,
it away.
Here I am live and direct from Greenfield's Oscars Theater, where all chaos has ensued. Real famous boy band, the Jacksons, have been kidnapped. They are MIA. Nobody knows their whereabouts. Nobody has any clues, and nobody has seen anything. It is a very, very strange circumstances, and we hope to have the story for you as it breaks, so make sure to stay tuned.
Whoa, my goodness, did you hear that, baby Angel? The Jacksons, that boy band, they're after being kidnapped.
I know, and you know what? They're actually my favorite boy band ever!
Oh my goodness, okay, well this sounds like a job for Detective Ropo and Detective Baby Angel, so I think we should get our detective clothes on and get down there as soon as possible.
Come on, Ropo!
Okay, this is where the tracks have led, Baby Angel. This is Little Lizard's high school, so...
I know!
I don't really think she's gonna hide a boy band here, because
well,
I mean...
Well, you never know!
Yeah, but there's so many people here. There's like so many kids. Tiny Turtle will be
actually,
here. Little Lizard will be here.
That's true. Why would she check them to such a populated... Oh my gosh!
Do you see what I see?
It's the car!
It's the gross beige car!
It's the gross beige car.
Oh my goodness. Okay, well, obviously she is the worst driver ever because this is totally crashed. She nearly crashed into a tree.
Because there's so many people around, as you pointed out.
Oh my goodness. Okay, so she must have came in one of these back doors. Let me
Ropo,
see. Let me
Ropo,
check it out.
Ropo,
What is it?
I have to prepare myself. What if they're dead?
You can't think like that. There's no way.
Okay.
There's no way.
Okay.
She couldn't. Okay,
okay,
let me see. I can't get in these doors. They're locked. Let me see. No. All this entrance is locked too.
Oh my gosh, I see blood.
Uh-oh.
And I see a pair of booties!
Uh-oh, okay, there's boots.
Oh, let me sniff them.
What the? Oh, gross.
Oh, they definitely belong to Stevie. Ropo, I am worried. No, come back! Sorry, I just made you puke up.
That's so gross. Did you just sniff a guy's shoes?
Yes, they're definitely Stevie Jackson's, and I'm terrified!
How do you know if they're Stevie Jackson's?
Because they smell like what I imagine Stevie Jackson to smell like!
You can't just guess what he
yes,
smells
you
like.
Can. Can't you understand that my dream, my future, I plan to marry this guy, is like possibly dead inside and we're just dilly-dallying, wasting time?
Yeah, I know, but we need to take a step back here for a second and realize what you did.
I took a step back.
Okay, you just sniffed
what?
A guy's shoes. That's like he's got smelly feet, and then you know it's him because of his smelly feet.
Look, it doesn't sound logical, but it is to me. Just trust me. I have a female instinct. I have a gut, and I know what I'm talking about. This is his blood. I can tell. Look, it's shaped like a love heart. It's a sign. It's a love heart. It's
no,
a sign.
They're footprints.
It's a love heart.
Okay, it's a love heart.
Sorry, I'm going crazy.
Let's follow the blood. Okay, well, it's not good that one of them is bleeding, but it's leading right into the school.
Oh, well, gosh, I'm so scared to go inside. Oh, these doors are making so much
okay,
noise.
Okay, let's see. This is the auditorium.
Are they in there?
Let me just
Stevie
check.
Jackson!
We just walked in the middle of a lecture.
Yeah,
quick, get up. Oh, quick.
I don't want to be in trouble.
Whoops.
I don't want to go to detention.
No,
wait,
nor do
can we
I.
Can we still go to detention even though we're detectives?
I think so, but...
Oh, look! Oh, it's the same.
Performing
more blood,
arts...
More blood! Ropo!
What is it?
There's more blood on the floor! It says... Oh my gosh, it says keep out basement.
Okay, keep out basement. Okay, well, it says keep out. Come on, so let's keep looking.
Oh, okay, well, we can just look in another room.
Dancing room.
The dancing room! I want to have a boogie!
Yeah, okay, there's a lot of people... Wait a second, hold on, baby Angel!
What?
Well, we're not students, we don't have to keep out. They must be down in the basement!
Oh my gosh, yes! Let's go! Good thinking, Ropo! Gosh, okay. I'm so used to being obedient!
Oh no, okay. Oh no, there's blood in the walls! There's blood in the walls!
Oh dear, this is not looking promising! I'm scared!
Whoa! Oh no! It's the girl! But look, we found the man!
Are you guys okay?
Goodness! Hang tight! Okay, wait. Okay, we have to go arrest her.
Attack her!
Okay, no, we can't attack her. She's only a teenager.
Whoa! Calm down!
Okay, you! I can't believe you did it! You kidnapped the band!
Yeah, you're admitting it, you crazy girl! What were you thinking? Excuse me, you are under arrest! You are under arrest!
Oh my god, I'm sorry. The Jacksons? I thought they were One Direction. Ugh, gross. You can take them. But am I gonna go to jail?
Jail? Yeah, of course you're going to jail, Missy. You just stole everybody's flavor, play by never.
Yeah, well, I think we're gonna have to leave this one up to the cops, but don't move because we have to go rescue Baby Angel's favorite boy band. Come on, Rick!
I'm gonna go save Stevie.
do you need like one guy?
I basically just know one guy, yeah.
Okay, come on, smash this down. Smashy.
Hello,
all right,
we're
nice.
Here to save you.
Oh my goodness, she had dog bowls for him.
Oh my gosh, that's disgusting. Hey, Stevie.
Okay,
hey,
guys. You're free to
go. Oh my
gosh,
there's a skeleton here. That's ew.
This is pretty gross. But yeah, guys, we saved you and you're free to go. I'd like you to meet Baby Angel. She pretty much is your number one fan.
Yeah, I am a huge fan. Robo, go over there for a second. I'm just gonna, you know, talk to the guys. What's that thing to Stevie? Oh my gosh, just one second. Oh my gosh, Robo.
What?
Stevie Jackson, you know, of the Jacksons.
I can see him. He's right there.
He just asked me out on a date.
What? You're too young to be going on a date.
No, I'm not.
Sir, what are your intentions with my baby sister?
No, just leave him alone. Just stop being embarrassing. Stop embarrassing me. Stop it.
Fine. All right. Whatever. We'll talk about this when we get home, all right?
I'll see you soon, Stevie. What time will you pick me up on Saturday?
What time?
Fine, I'll call you. Actually, you call me. You're the gentleman. Well, this is it. There's no going back now. Here I am at the Big Ship Festival, and I'm about to go on a hot date with one of the world's biggest rock stars. I don't even know how these things happen to me, but I'm so excited. But I'm also a little bit nervous. The butterflies in my tummy are making me want to go poop. I know, not exactly a good look. But I think you'd be feeling nervous too if you were meeting Stevie Jackson of the Jacksons. I mean, I'm trying not to even think about it too much. It's just far too cool for me, far too cool. All right, what have we got here? Ooh, this is beautiful. Oh, I'm already so excited! What a gorgeous Ferris wheel! Wow! I promised Stevie I'd call him when I got here, so here goes nothing! Right, his number. 555-432. It's ringing! Hello? Is that Stevie Jackson?
Hey, Baby Angel.
Oh, hey! I can't believe you answered! Hi! I'm here, but I can't find you!
I think I can see you.
Oh, you can?
Is that you?
Yeah, that's me with the blonde hair, yeah. Where are you? Oh, I think I see you. Just one second. Stevie Jackson, I see you!
How are you, Baby Angel?
Oh, you know, I'm good. Oh, we should probably get off our phones now, though, that we're face-to-face. How are you doing? Are you good?
I'm good. I'm sorry I got delayed. I was rehearsing with the band, you know, for my big show later.
Oh, don't worry about it. Are you looking forward to performing tonight?
I can't wait. We're gonna rock this place like a rockin' ship.
I bet. You gonna show me around or what?
Yeah, sounds like a great idea. Let's do that.
So I was wondering, Stevie, why did you invite me here?
I don't know, there's just something about you. I can't put my finger on it, you know, but you... I have a feeling this is gonna be a great date.
Oh, right, this is a date?
If you think it's a date...
It's just that, dates make me a little nervous.
Okay. Let's not call it a date. Let's call it a fun time at a fun festival with a super girl and a cool guy.
Oh, cool. Well, I'm looking forward... with you on our non-date. So let's go do something. Come on, Al. Enough yakking. Hey, Stevie, I was wondering...
What were you wondering?
Are you feeling adventurous?
I'm always feeling adventurous with you, baby.
Aw, so sweet. Well, I was wondering, do you want to go on a roller coaster?
Of course. Yes, yeah, I'd love to go on a roller coaster with you.
Oh, sweet. Well, why do you keep walking away? I'm a little confused.
Well, I've always been afraid of roller coasters. And, I don't know, I could just never find the courage to get on a roller coaster. They kind of freak me out a little.
I'll hold your hand. You have nothing to worry about. I'll protect you, Stevie. Although it is kind of funny that you're a rock star who's afraid of roller coasters, you know? You're meant to be cool and stuff.
Yeah, I'm pretty embarrassed about the whole thing.
Oh, well, don't worry. I've got your back. This is gonna be so much fun.
I'm sorry about that, baby angel. I didn't mean to. I'm sorry.
Oh, don't worry about it. Your secret's safe with me. I'm just glad that you're okay. But I still think you need to go on the roller coaster with me. Come on, let's be adventurous. I won't tell anyone about the puke.
Please don't tell anybody that I'm scared of roller coasters. And I really didn't mean to you know.
Spew all over me.
Yeah, spew all over you, yeah.
Meh, I've forgotten about it already. Come on, Barface. Last one to the roller coasters is Square. Oh, come on, Stevie. Are you following me, you big chicken? Oh, the tiny coaster. Oh, what's this say? Free carts, instructions. There are no instructions. Just have fun. Oh, love is in the air. No backing out now, mister. Whee! I'm having so much fun! Woo! Best time ever! Woo! Oh, no! Not again! Oh, Stevie, that's a lot of puke! You're such a chicken! Never mind. Come on, let's go have some more fun! Last one to make it to the concert entrance smells like a cow's bum! Race ya!
Hey, baby angel, I'd like to introduce you to some of my friends.
I would absolutely love that.
But, you know, they don't like to be interrupted when they're dancing.
Oh, that's okay. I love to dance, too. Let's meet them. Ah, this is like my favorite song ever. Let me dance with you. Come on, show me what you got.
Yeah, I've got a few moves up my sleeve. I like to practice at home in the shower.
You're so funny. Stevie, keep calm, but I'm pretty sure I see the gingerbread man over there.
Oh, yeah. I don't know. Are you a fan?
Fan? Shrek is my favorite movie. You mean you know him?
Me and Ginger, we go back a long way. Yeah, I met him, you know. I used to play in a band with him when I was starting off. And, you know, he's a great drummer. Really good. But you know, he met Shrek, and they went into the movie business, and now he's a really successful Hollywood actor.
That is, like, so cool how you know him. You are just the coolest person I've ever met.
You know, I got an idea. Why don't we do something that the two of us can enjoy together?
Ooh, I would absolutely love that! What do you have in mind?
Well, you know, it's a surprise, but it's just follow me and I'll show you.
Intriguing! Where are you taking me? Can you give me a clue? Oh, right. Mysterious. You're not gonna say anything? Oh, I bet you this is gonna be magnificent! Oh, wow. This way? So from the way you're acting, acting, I kind of know that this is something special. So should I, like, turn around or wear a blindfold or something? What do you think?
Maybe close your eyes and turn around and you walk backwards. I'll make sure you don't walk off and fall into the ocean.
You're so funny. Aw.
Okay, right. So, slowly, a little bit more.
Uh-huh.
Okay, stop. Now turn around 3 times. Just trust me on this.
Okay. 1, 2, 3.
Now jump up and down 7 times.
7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Okay, And now, open your eyes.
Oh, my beating heart! This is amazing! Did you do this for me, Stevie?
Yeah, it's just something I put together earlier on, you know? Before my rehearsal with my band.
You mean you were thinking about me today?
Yeah, a little bit. I suppose you could say that. You know, I like the way you can walk backwards and not fall into the ocean.
Well, I suppose it is a skill. Aw, shucks, I'm blushing. Thank you.
It's pretty magnificent. But, I suppose this food is gonna get cold. We should probably, you know, start eating. I'm sure you're hungry.
Oh, yeah, I'm famished. Let's go have a closer look. Oh, goodness, it's so beautiful. Wow. Stevie, you old romantic. I love it! Aww, it's so nice!
I got some really good pizza. I flew it in from New York.
Oh, Stevie! You've gone through so much effort for me! Thank you! I love it all. Let's sit down and enjoy this delicious meal! Just the two of us!
Oh my god! This is like the most delicious meal that I've ever had! It's so tasty! I love pizzas!
Wow, do you always eat that loud or make that much noise?
Am I eating loud? I didn't even notice! This pizza's so tasty! And this is so good!
So, pardon my rudeness, Stevie. Sometimes I just get too excited around food. Tell me more about you. I want to know everything.
Well, you know, did I mention that I play in a band?
Only once or twice.
Well, I like to write songs and play in a band. You know, I sing and... Baby angel, yay.
Wow, you're so skillful.
You see, that's I suppose you would call it a skill. You know, I just call it a passion.
I know all about passions. I'm really passionate about something, too. I love reindeer. I just don't know what it is about them. I am obsessed. I know. It's kind of odd.
Oh, well, that's funny that you mentioned that. You know, I just bought a reindeer park.
You did? Are you kidding me? That is awesome!
I've got, like, 271 reindeer. I'd go through all the names, but there's so many of them I'd be here all day. But, yeah, I'd love for you to see all my reindeers.
Ugh, that just sounds delightful. What are the chances we'd have that in common, eh? You're so random. So tell me, Stevie, what did you think when you first saw me? Because, I thought you were so freaking hot! I thought you were cute.
You know, at first, I thought you were some kind of giant butterfly, and I'm scared of butterflies, so... I was kind of scared, and I wanted to cry and run away and scream. But then, you know, you looked in my eyes, and I don't know, I just couldn't explain it.
Oh!
Baby angel, you came along and saved me. Yeah, I don't know.
You're funny, Stevie Jackson. Really, really funny. So we should probably get going. I mean, this food has been delicious, but you have a show tonight, don't forget.
Yeah, but you know, show, schmo. I do shows every day and every night. I was thinking...
What? What were you thinking? That's a very long pause.
I just got another idea for a song.
Okay...
Baby angel, Baby angel, look at you standing there with your blonde hair, baby angel.
Oh, stop it! I'm actually sitting.
Oh, baby angel, look at you sitting there on a boat eating pizza, making lots of noises. It's a bit weird that you're making so much noise eating pizza in this boat, but I love it, baby angel. Yay!
Dede Jackson, you are bonkers, but I love it. Thanks for serenading me. I feel so special.
Hey, don't worry about it. I'd love to do it again soon if that is, of course, if you'd like to join me on another date.
Are you kidding me? I would love that so much! Yes, yes, yes! Please, let's go on another date! Woo!
Hey, cool, calm down. It's cool, you know?
Oh, that dinner was so delicious, Stevie! Thank you so much! Oh, what's this? Wow! Viewing deck? Oh, gosh, it's so high! Be careful, vertigo possible. Stevie? Did you run away? Come back! Vertigo isn't that bad. I mean, you did well on the roller coaster. This won't be moving. Oh, it's starting to rain. Come on, hurry up. I want us to go up and take a view of the entire carnival. Come on, it won't be that bad. Ugh, I live for this romantic, smushy stuff. off I go. Ooh, it is so high! Wow, that is a gorgeous view! Oh my gosh, I can see it all! It's so nice! Ah, this is my favorite view of all. Beautiful! What do you think? Oh, right, Stevie, what are you doing sitting there? you can't be that afraid. Really, it's okay. Are you crying?
No, I'm not crying. I'm just, you know, I'm happy. She spent all this time as a baby. All the time as a baby, yeah.
No, I'm being serious, Stevie. I don't know how to say this, but I'm a little shy about this. I've never been kissed, and I really like you. I really do. And I was hoping that you'll like me too, and that you, you know, would wanna smooch. Or kiss me or something.
Wants to go for a kiss. She's never had a kiss before in her life.
Quit making fun of me. I'm being serious.
Sorry. Sometimes just, you know, people say things and I just have to sing. I have to write a song about it and, you know, never had a kiss before in her life.
You know, Stevie Jackson, I'll say this once and once only. Shut up and kiss me.
Whoa, okay.
Gosh, that was magical!
I think you just made my heart go pop. It did it again. Maybe I should go see a doctor. I just kissed baby angel. Yeah!
Stevie Jackson, you're something else! I really like you! Come on, let's get out of here! Oh, goodness me, Stevie! You know I really like you, but can you just please stop with the singing?
I'm sorry, baby angel. You know, I mean, I've just never done this date thing before, and when I'm really nervous, I sing. And I'm sorry. Just, I'll try not to sing. Yeah. Okay, right. I'm gonna stop singing from now on. Baby angel, are you having fun with me?
Uh-huh. You betcha.
Oh, you look so beautiful today with the sun in the sky. Yeah, shining like a sun in the sky, baby angel, yeah.
Oh, stop it, you. Come on, let's get going.
Baby angel, I just really want to do this again sometime, but I hope you can make a show in the future. But before you go, there's something I want to say. I had such a great time with you on this date, and I'd love to do it again sometime, baby angel, if you don't mind. I would love to take you out on another date. What do you say?
Keep dreaming, sunshine! No way! Absolutely no way!
You just broke my little heart, baby angel. I don't know what to do now. My heart is aching. It's broken and it's shaking up inside of me.
I'm just kidding with you, Stevie. I would love that so much. But you have to promise me one thing.
Yeah?
You don't have to sing every minute of every hour of every single day. All right? I don't expect that of you. You can just talk. It's fine.
Yeah, I can cut the... Yeah, I'm sorry. Yeah, I just, you know, I sing when I'm nervous. I told you that. I'm sorry. Yeah, I'll work on it, baby angel. I'll work on it.
Sweet!
I'll see you soon, baby angel. I'll see you soon. See you soon, baby angel. I'll see you soon. See you soon, baby angel. I'll see you soon. See you soon, baby angel. I'll see you soon.
Oh, you little rascal! I can't wait till the next date already. Here, give me a kiss. Mwah! Bye, Stevie Jackson! I gotta go up late for Oppo! Call me! Oh my goodness, it's just the most perfect day in the whole wide world. The hot air balloon is in the sky, which means a gentle breeze. The sun is shining and I'm here at the airport for my first solo adventure. I'm so excited and my cab driver seems to have gone missing, so I guess I can't pay him. Oh well! I am so excited to go to New York City! I've never been there before, so I really don't know what to expect, but I can assure you one thing, it's gonna be awesome. Alright, security checkpoint. Hello, ma'am. My name is Baby Angel. I'm going on a little adventure to see my boyfriend, Stevie Jackson. He's really handsome and is in a famous band. And I really, really hope you'll let me through because, basically he's waiting for me and he's expecting me. So I'll be back in 2 days and I'll be staying in a hotel. So can I go through, please?
Why, aye, Baby Angel. You can go through. Have a great holiday and enjoy your time with the wonderful Stevie Jackson. I'm also a big fan. New York City is very magical. Have the best time ever.
Oh, fantastic! Oh, this is so exciting. Oh, New York City, New York City. If only I was tall enough to see. Let me take a step back. And, yeah, this isn't really working out too well for me. I can't really, tell. Who can I ask for help? Oh, maybe, this guy. Excuse me, sir. I'm going to New York City. Can you please tell me which gate it is?
Sure thing, little lady. Let's check the board and see. Aha! Gate 24C. Check in with Rainbow Airlines.
Oh, thank you so much. I'm gonna have the best holiday ever. Thanks for helping me.
Have a great
You're very
trip.
Fine. Thank you, sir. Oh, wow. Hey, what's down here? Gate 24Z. Oh, this kind of looks like arrivals or something to do with suitcases and picking them up. I am definitely in the wrong area. Let me get out of here. Of course I had to go the wrong way. All right, Rainbow Airlines, I'm coming at ya. Which way? I'm gonna go for this way. It just seems the most appropriate, so Air France, boring, information. Oh, Rainbow, yes! Ride the Rainbow. Who doesn't want to, hello, lady. I want to ride the Rainbow. and I also have a ticket to NYC, please. This is Baby Angel checking in.
Oh, gosh, you are very welcome, Baby Angel. I got one VIP ticket for you all the way from here to NYC. Thank you for choosing to ride the Rainbow. You may now proceed to the airline.
Oh, wonderful. Thank you so much, ma'am. You have no idea how excited I am.
thank you so much. I'm so excited. Oh, I found the plane.
Attention, please. This is a call for passenger Baby Angel. Your flight today has changed from Rainbow Airlines to Little Donnie's private jet. Please enjoy your
awesome.
Journey and proceed.
I get an upgrade. Woo! Hello, lady. I'm Baby Angel, and I've just been upgraded to Little Donnie's private jet. So, I'm just gonna go now. Thank you. Bye. This is so cool. I've never even been on a private jet before. Look at it. It's gorgeous. All the way down the steps. And, this is probably where I should say goodbye to y'all. And I'll see you all the way in New York City. Let's hope it's not a bumpy ride.
Hey, here you go, madam. Here's your hotel.
Flight of NYC. I am so excited to be here amidst the tall buildings. And, this is gorgeous.
Have a wonderful time here in our wonderful city.
Why, thank you, sir. I'm gonna go and get checked in to my beautiful hotel. Oh, my phone is ringing. Where is it? Where is it? Oh, it's Stevie Jackson. Hello? Hi, Stevie. Yeah, it's me, Baby Angel. I just arrived at my hotel. I cannot wait to see you. What's going down? What are you at?
Baby Angel, I'm so sorry, but I won't be able to make it. I had a last-minute show in Ireland.
Okay.
My assistant was supposed to send you a memo to let you know. I'm guessing you never got it.
I didn't get it. No, it's not a problem. It's totally fine. I mean, don't even worry about it. It's fine. Totally fine. Not a problem. Totally fine. Can we maybe, reschedule for, another time? What do you say? Hello? Stevie? Did he hang up on me? Oh, what a horrible person. I'm done. I'm just kidding. I'm not done. I'm really upset. Oh, why me? Why me? But you know what? It's fine. I'm gonna stop crying and I'm gonna have the best time ever because I'm in New York City and I deserve to have an adventure. Who needs boys anyway? Who needs rock stars? Stevie Jackson, I'll show you. I'll show you that I can have a good time without even needing you. Yeah, that's it. Rafa!
Baby Angel, I really need you to, Can you bring me over 10 donuts, 10 Fantas, another 10 donuts, and maybe some fruit?
Yeah, sure, no problem. I'll just go get you your random order of a bajillion donuts and a bajillion drinks and a bajillion other things. So weird. He acts so strange, that brother, sometimes. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We only pretty much have 10. Did he say 10 donuts? He's gonna get so pudgy-wudgy if he's not careful. But whatever. Like, he's his own person. Strawberry. Oh, 15. Oh, well, I just get an extra Fanta. Oh, my goodness. Oh, I have way too many things. Rumpo! I accidentally picked up way too many things, but I hope you don't mind. Did you just switch the channel?
Switch the channel? Me? No.
Are you sure? Because I'm pretty sure I heard Jimmy Fallon's voice coming off the TV.
No, I wasn't watching Jimmy Fallon. What are you talking about?
What are you doing and why are you acting suspicious? You never eat so much junk anyway watching TV. Or period. Come on, put the TV back on. You know it's my favorite show. Unless there's something on there you don't want me to see. Come on, come clean. What is it, Ropo? You know you can tell me anything.
Nothing. Not trying to hide anything at all. All right. I was trying to save you from getting your heart crushed again. That Stevie Jackson guy, he's on Jimmy Fallon tonight.
What? He is? Oh my, that is a little bit, strange, I suppose. Look, I don't mind watching it. Come on, flick on the TV. I gotta see this for myself. I mean, did you know that I actually bumped into him the other day? Well, I didn't bump in, but I saw him cross the street when I was with Baby Max. It was the strangest thing in the world because then Baby Max kind of got weird about it, but it was totally fine. Come on, just put on the telly. What are you waiting for? Put it on!
Coming to you live from the Big Apple, New York City, The Tonight Show with Jimmy Fallon.
I met this girl one time, and I treated her bad. I haven't seen her since, but this song's for her. Baby Angel, I miss you.
Whoa! Whoa, whoa, whoa! That was just too much, Robo! What is going on? Stevie Jackson on national TV talking about me?
What? Oh, please! This is his way of getting you back after leaving you stranded in New York City? Seriously? Baby Angel, I'm not usually a bossy brother, but I'm afraid I'm gonna have to step in here. You are forbidden from ever seeing Stevie Jackson again. He's bad, bad news. Stay away from him. You hear?
Stay away from him? Are you kidding me? I've been as far away from him as possible. I mean, I've made my life better without him, and everything's going fine and smoothly, and then boom! He arrives back in my life, Ropo. This is big news. I mean, I know he's been a jerk in the past, but...
No buts. Besides, you have Baby Max, and he is a true gentleman. Broken hearts aren't fun, Baby Angel. Trust me. Promise me you'll stay away, all right?
Oh, all right. I suppose you do make some sense.
Sweet. Because I will really, really, really be mad if I hear you went anywhere near this Stevie guy again.
Oh, Robo, I won't do it, okay? It's fine. It's just... I don't know what to do. Like, I'm just... I'm really caught up about it. I need a moment to think.
I mean, like, whoa, what just happened there? One second I'm watching TV, and then all of a sudden, one of the world's biggest rock stars is saying my name on national television and saying that he misses me? Whoa! I don't really know how I'm supposed to be feeling. All I know is that it's just... Well, should I listen to Robo and just... Oh, it's snowing! How beautiful! Should I just listen to Robo? And just ignore Stevie Jackson? Or should I give him just one quick text message and say, Stevie, I've missed you so much, but you were such a jerk, but I would still like to see you again because you were the first boy that made my heart beat super fast. I mean, some would say that that's a really stupid move, but I'm just so unsure. Of course I like Baby Max. He's just the sweetest guy in the world, but... I really don't know what to do. What do you guys think? How should I do? How should I go about this? I mean, I'm feeling really confused right now. And if Baby Max knew, his heart would actually be broken. This is true. Who am I kidding? I don't want to be alone in the treehouse. Maybe I can... I don't know. I just really need somebody to talk to about all of this. Because this is going to be a disaster. How am I supposed to forget that something like that ever happened? I know my promise to Ruppo was to never see Stevie Jackson again, but I don't trust myself. I'm gonna have to call him. Yep, it's gonna have to be done. I mean, come on. Okay, I have to think this through super well. What exactly am I gonna say? Okay, I'll just say, hi, Stevie Jackson. I saw you on the TV, and you were super hot. I mean, cute. I mean, not cute at all. And it made me realize that I really miss you. And can we meet up, please? Because we have to talk. And I was really unhappy about the way you treated me in New York City. But, everybody deserves a second chance. I have a boyfriend now, by the way, so I just want to be friends. And, yeah. Oh, my phone is actually ringing. Hello? Oh, hi, Baby Max.
Hey, babe.
What's
just
up?
Just checking in on my favorite superhero. How are you?
I'm good. I'm just chilling at home in the kitchen with Chef. It's all decorated for Christmas now, which I didn't even realize was happening, but Robo had some decorators in. I'm having a nice day. I've got a present for you sitting under the tree beside the snowman. I just ate a burger and I was watching TV and that's about it, really. Yeah.
So, you still fancy going to somebody's phone on Friday? Date night.
Friday? Of course. I always want to see you, Baby Max. Friday sounds lovely. I shall wear my finest clothes and we will have a fantastic time together. Thank you very much. I'm all good for Friday. So sounds like a plan.
Aw, sweet. Can't wait to see you.
I can't wait to see you too, Baby Max. I'll see you then. I'll see you Friday. Bye-bye. Remember, you're the best. The snow keeps up. Imagine! Oh, a snow day would be fantastic. And there's the jolly man in the red suit looking all handsome and stuff. What? I wasn't expecting any guests. Who could it be? Maybe it's Baby Max here to surprise me, or Baby Leah, or maybe even Baby Zach, or it could be little Carly. The door is open. Hello? Hello, hello, hello? Oh. It doesn't look like anyone's outside. Interesting. All right, I'll just close the door to be safe as chips, and I can go inside and just chill. Oh, it's the door again. Weird. If this is a crank call, I will not be happy. Hello? O-M-G. What are you doing here? You, of all people, what are you doing turning up on my door? You are an evil person, and I do not want to see you. Stevie Jackson, what are you doing at my front door? What's happening?
Baby, Angel, all I need is you. I love you, Baby Angel. I will fight for you.
You are not welcome on my doorstep. You have been a horrible person to me. How did you even get my address? Do you know what? This is totally awkward because I have a boyfriend and I love him a lot. And you do not deserve to be here. After seeing you on Jimmy Fallon, I was disgusted. Absolutely disgusted with your behavior. It confused my heart and it made me really angry. I chose Baby Max in the end and I love him. So please, get lost!
Baby Angel, I don't care if you have a boyfriend. I mean, I just love you so much. You know, I'd do anything and give anything to have you back in my arms.
Do anything? Give anything? You are out of your mind, mister! What kind of guy does this? You are crazy! Crazy! You think that I'm going to forgive you after everything that you did to me? Are you serious? Baby Max is the best, most loyalest, kindest, sweetest boyfriend ever! Ever, 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 ever!
And you say you have a boyfriend? Then I want to meet him. And I want to meet him now. I want to look him in the eye, man to man, and then I want to give him one of these.
Ooh, yeah! Are you for real? Baby Max is more of a man than you will ever be, and he's not even a man, he's a dog, and he is the best creature I have ever met. He would never have treated me the way you have treated me. Ugh, Stevie, you're making me so angry.
A dog? Wow, that's really rough. I still want to meet him, and I'll bring some dog treats. I love you, Baby Angel.
Love? Love? What do you know about love, Stevie Jackson? What do you know about love? You tell me what you know about love.
I don't know anything about love, but I do know that whatever love is, I definitely love you.
Oh, please, you're making me sick with all your lies. You're making me sick. Ugh. I don't even know what to say to you. Just go away and leave me alone. Get out of my life.
What is going on here? I mean, I'm the rock star. Love me, baby angel. Don't go away with this Justin fella.
Justin? Who's Justin? My boyfriend's name is Baby Max. Baby Max. Max. M-A-X. Max. Not Justin. Sheesh, you're just like the rudest person in the world. I can't believe I was gonna even give you a chance. I can't believe I got so sad about you. Ugh, whatever. So fun exploring a whole new place.
Like, OMG, are you the real baby angel? Is this the girl I have heard so much about the last few days?
Heard so much about? I don't know what you mean. Do we know each other? Should I?
Oh my, you don't know anything about this? Don't you know that people have been talking? People have been saying some really nasty things about you, and it's all got to do with one guy and one guy only. Well, actually, two guys. According to Greenfield and talk on the town, you're a cheater.
Whoa! What? Me? A cheater? What are you talking about?
You're cheating on Baby Max with Stevie Jackson, world-renowned rock star. Is this true?
True? It couldn't be more untrue. I mean, who's been talking bad about me and saying all this stuff? I mean, it's ridiculous. Can you tell me who has been saying this stuff, please?
Oh, I'm not giving away any sources. All I'll say is that I have friends in really high places who know Baby Max, and they walked by your house, and they thought they saw Stevie Jackson at your door. Now, I'm not saying that that's weird or anything, but I mean, it doesn't look right, does it? When you've got a boyfriend and some rock star is outside your door. You know, it's gonna get the town talking.
The whole town talking? I mean, what is there to talk about? There is absolutely nothing to talk about. Nothing happened. He turned him at my door. He revealed that he loves me and that he's so sorry for sending me up, blah, 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 blah. But nothing happened. I mean, no. I love Baby Max. Nothing happened.
Girl, I don't care what went on. All I know is that people are saying really nasty stuff about you, and I'm just giving you a warning to back off.
Back off? Don't you think you're being a little harsh with me? Seriously?
We're just looking out for Baby Max. I don't care what you're saying. It's in my position to tell you that Baby Max is precious, and you should behave yourself, or else.
Oh my goodness, you're threatening me. I can't believe you're threatening me over something that I didn't even do. That's just... it's just so mean. He just turned up at my house. It meant nothing. It meant nothing to me. I love Baby Max. I mean, you know, I can't help what Stevie Jackson does. If he turns up and professes his love, I can't help that.
Yeah. He just turned up at your door. So you keep saying, like, OMG, there are so many girls out there. Why would he turn up at your door of all doors? You know what I mean? And, like, my friends are huge fans of the Jacksons, but this isn't coming out of jealousy or anything. Nobody's being jealous. I mean, he's just Stevie Jackson. He's a lead singer. He's in a rock band. He's ridiculously hot. But it's not coming out of jealousy. No one is jealous here. I'm just looking out for your welfare and for the welfare of Baby Max and for the girlhood and the sisterhood. Please, girlfriend, behave yourself and stay away from that rock star. Like, OMG. Ugh.
Ay, ay, ay. Look, lady, I don't even know your name, but one thing is for sure. I really just do not appreciate you talking to me like this. It's so rude and so... it's just rude. You should mind your own business. I really do not appreciate it. Like, come on.
You don't appreciate me saying this? Well, we don't appreciate you stealing Stevie Jackson.
Stealing Stevie Jackson? You know what? You can have him. Have him. I don't care.
Yeah, that's right. Be a crybaby. Go cry. Go cry at home. Go cry at home to your superhero brother, who's also really cute and super... just get a grip, baby angel. As if Phoebe Jackson would ever want to be with someone like you.
All of you know I'm a really great person, and that I do not deserve this, and that karma will come and get you, lady. Karma will find you, and karma will get you. I gotta go home. This has been such a nightmare. All I wanted to do was surprise Phoebe Jackson. Transform his house into something really special for us. And it's just backfired on me. Honey, I'm sitting here flicking through all these messages from those horrible girls. I mean, the gang of girls. I don't know how they got my number, but they're calling me everything from a liar to a loser to a cheat to, like, a lowlife. And to be honest, it's uncalled for. I haven't done anything wrong, and it's making me so sad. It's kind of a form of bullying, to be honest. I mean, oh no, who is it this time? Hello?
You think your secret's safe? Everybody knows. And I mean everyone, you pathetic little girl. You're such a loser!
I haven't done anything wrong! Leave me alone!
You loser! Stop loser! Playing. Loser!
Sure that I liked it. Did a boy come to visit you a few days ago? Some rock star?
Well, yes, kind of, but also no. He wasn't really visiting me, Baby Max. Why? What's wrong? I mean, we are gonna have to sit down and talk about it, but I promise you have nothing to worry about. Why do you ask?
Well, because it makes me very sad.
No, don't be sad. Look, basically, I told this guy to get lost, and that you're the only guy for me this Christmas. The only guy for me ever. You're the only guy I want to kiss under the mistletoe. You know what I mean?
Oh, I knew it. I knew I had nothing to worry about. I'll see you soon, Baby Angel. I gotta run. I just had to stop by real quick to see if the rumors were true. So glad they're not.
Okay, bye, Baby Max. Look, I do want to sit down and talk to you about all of this, okay? We need to talk. We've got some explaining to do. I mean, I've got some explaining to do. There's no we other than me. Just me and you. We're the only we. Anyway, thank you for stopping by, and please don't be sad. I love you, and I'll see you later. Bye! Oh my goodness, when did life get so complicated? One moment it was simple, the next, boom, everything is wrong. Oh, now I have to sort out these parts. Seriously, my phone is ringing again? Hello? Hello?
Baby Angel, you're so pathetic. Look at you with your pathetic face. You're such a loser, a cheater, a loser.
Again. I'm seriously gonna have to report these girls. Oh, it's funny, I haven't been here in so long. Oh, Detective Carlos. Hello, sir. It's been a while since I've seen you. Listen, I have a bit of an awkward problem today. How should I put this? My life is in turmoil at the moment, and it's because of a bunch of mean girls. Now, I'm not sure if I should have come to you or not, but basically they're calling me nonstop and saying really mean things and then hanging up, and it's making my life really miserable. I was wondering if Detective Carlos, hi, you could please, help me out, please?
This sounds like a nasty case of bullying to me, Baby Angel. You've done the right thing coming here. Let's run these numbers through our system and see what we can dig up. I won't be a moment.
Okay, no problem. I'll be right here just pacing the floor. Gosh, I'm so nervous. I hope you can find something. I really need a resolution, and I need a fast. Oh, dear.
Detective Carlos, are you okay? You seem a little bit, off. Is everything fine?
No, everything is not okay. I'm extremely angry and incredibly embarrassed, not to mention disappointed. Our data files traced those phone numbers to Angelica Houston and Katie Jane Simpson, my daughter's best friends.
Oh my, that's kind of awkward. That's such unfortunate news for both you and I don't know what to say.
I'll have to have some very stern words with their parents this evening. I'm incredibly sorry. I can assure you these phone calls will stop. And if you'd like, I can contact Stevie Jackson's managers and issue a restraining order. Let me know how you'd like to proceed. My phone number is 7765-47143.
Oh, no. A restraining order won't be necessary. It's fine. But I would appreciate if you spoke to their parents, please. Because what they're doing to me is nasty, and it's making me sad and afraid, and I just think it comes out of pure jealousy, and I hope that nobody ever does that to them. And also, I hope they don't get in too much trouble, but, you know, enough trouble so that they know what they're doing is really bad. Detective Carlos, I'll keep your phone number and I'll let you know if anything else needs to be done. Thank you so much for your time. I really appreciate it. I'm gonna go now and maybe change my number or something. Thank you, sir. And please don't be too mad at your daughter for hanging out with those girls. It's just, some people are confused, and that's probably why they're being nasty. See you later, and thank you for your time. Thank you so much. What do you mean look at the news? Has something happened? Is Robo okay? What do you mean you can't explain? Somebody needs to explain. What's happening? What? Go to the town center, but I had plans. I was supposed to wrap up all my presents tonight. Are you sure this is a good plan? Okay, well, if you say so, I'll be right on my way. Thanks for the heads up, I think. Oh, Lord. Something weird is going on. I just got a really interesting phone call telling me that I better make my way into Greenfields because there's something I need to see. Detective Carlos wouldn't lie to me like this. And I suppose I should listen to him. I mean, he has been so good on this case. He's been looking out for me ever since the girls have started harassing me. And, yeah, it's good to have an adult on my team. Alright, I'm gonna do this. I'm gonna head in. But I just don't know what to prepare myself for. I think he said to check out the McDonald's, right? So, off I go. McDonald's, we're so... Oh, there's a text message coming through. And it's from Baby Leah. What does it say? OMG, I can't believe this is happening. Are you alright? How do you feel? What a strange message. What is happening and why is it such a big deal to everybody? Seriously, Baby Leah's... Oh. Baby Angel, do you... want to be my girlfriend? What? Do I have a secret admirer? Wow, I am so embarrassed. Look at the size of the picture of my face. I'm wearing my dummy, like, come on. And the love hearts, and do you want to be my girl? This is really romantic, but, like, O-M-G. There are more posters? I love you so much? What? And I love you and heartbeats? Do you want to be my girlfriend again? And even more? Baby Angel, I love you. I love you so much. I love you. I love you. Oh my goodness, this is very, very weird. Who would do such a extravagant thing that's horrifically embarrassing? Oh my goodness. Oh, if only I could change my face. I don't want people to know it's me. Oh, I better hurry on. Well, that was embarrassing.
Oh, look, it's that girl all over the posters.
Those girls.
Oh my god, what? You're like so weird.
My face is a teddy bear. This is so embarrassing. This is humiliating. Is this someone's idea of a joke? I mean, you mean the world to me? Is this Baby Max being a romantic but in a silly way? Because if it is, Baby Angel, I love you. Oh my gosh, if it is, then I really don't know what to say because, I mean, he's already told me that he cares for me. He doesn't need to do this. Oh my lord, it's everywhere. My face is just plastered. Oh god.
I'm not sure if you know, but your face is all
Yeah, that is my face, yeah. Oh no, I need to run somewhere and get myself some glasses. Oh man, where is the clothes store? I need myself some glasses. Come on, fast. Oh my goodness, I better hurry. Oh man, so much better. I feel like I can be more incognito now. Nobody needs to know that the girl on the poster is me. Oh lord, I better run. The whole town needs to be checked over. I feel like I'm everywhere. I feel like a movie star. I feel like I'm all of a sudden really, really famous. But I don't even like it. Seriously, here as well? Can the girl not even go to the park without feeling like everybody's watching her? This is out of order. I need to find out who is behind this right now. Ugh, maybe a trip to the cinema will do me good. You know, something angry and scary. Maybe a horror film, because this is just... it's just too much. It's like a movie or something, and I don't like it at all. I mean, really? There's posters scattered all around the town. I found this one on the ground, and it's gorgeous and romantic and everything, but, how do I put it? I want the ground to swallow me up, and I want to disappear. Okay, we'll just have to go to the cinema and pretend that the world is... What is he looking at? It's more posters of me. What? Oh no, I love you, Angel. Baby Angel, do you want to be my girlfriend? You mean the world to me. Excuse me, sir, did you by any chance see who put these posters? I need to go investigate if there's any more of this nonsense going on. What? I love you, Baby Angel. This is too much. This is so embarrassing. At least I can go and sit down and watch a movie. Wrong move. This is absolutely humiliating. Is there nowhere I can go without being confronted with pictures of myself? Huh? I need to get out of here real fast. This is so embarrassing. Finally, somewhere I can chill where my face isn't on every single wall. Oh man. I'm just gonna plop myself down here and try not to freak out. Oh no, my phone is ringing again. Yeah. Oh, it's a message. Stevie Jackson. Baby Angel, I hope you like... What? Stevie Jackson? Stevie Jackson is responsible for this? The posters around the town? He is responsible for this? I told him to go away. I told him to leave me alone. I think it's time for a phone call to Inspector Detective Carlos. Hello? Detective Carlos, it's Baby Angel. But you already know that. Listen, I found out who has been posting those, posters around the town. Yeah, plastering and, basically littering the town with my face. And I think you'll find it really interesting. It's Stevie Jackson, the rock star. I know because he sent me a message to say, did I like the surprises? Thankfully, he didn't call me, or I would have screamed down the phone at him. Detective Carlos, I think it's time for that restraining order. I really think it might be time. Oh, who is it now? This phone has been pinging like hotcakes. If it's not someone bullying me, it's silly text messages from people that I don't want to talk to. Oh, it's Stevie Jackson again. What does he want? Baby Angel, meet me in the park. It's important. Oh, meet me in the park. It's important. Meet me in the park. It's important. Do you know what? I will meet him in the park, and I will have a talk with him, and I'll tell this silly man what to do and where to go and put him in this place, because he's being ridiculous. He's just ridiculous. This is not how love works.
my way to give him a piece of my own mind!
Past the library, past Ed Sheeran, follow with us to the left, there's a gazebo, I've set up a dinner, yah, yah, yah. Oh, he has an everything. Okay, gotta stay strong. Hi, Stevie Jackson! Hey, why are you wearing a cape? Anyway, hi, Stevie! What's going down?
Baby Angel, I'm sure you've seen the billboards, and I'm really sorry if I embarrassed you, but yeah, I just want you to know that I love you. From the bottom of my heart, you're my moon, my stars, my morning air. You are the air in my lungs. You are my everything.
Look, Hotshot, I want nothing to do with you. I told you to stay away from me. You have made my life a misery. At first I liked you, but now look at me. I can't even walk around the town without wearing a disguise. People are talking about me, Stevie Jackson. You have made me a laughingstock. People have been bullying me. Can you understand this? And this is gorgeous and lovely, but I told you that I have a boyfriend and that I'm very happy with him, and you need to respect that. And you've made me so angry that I've done something that I'm not proud of, but I've spoken to the police. I'm sorry to say that, but I spoke to the police.
Baby Angel, you've been talking to the police? I mean, the police? Why would you do such a thing?
Yeah, I have, and it gets worse. It gets much, much worse than that, Stevie Jackson. They think that there are grounds for issuing a restraining order because you're stalking me and you won't leave me alone. And to be honest, I'm considering it. I'm considering a restraining order. And if you don't leave me alone, then I'll have to go through with it.
Baby Angel, please. I mean, I never meant to hurt you, and I never meant to make you feel uncomfortable. I'm really, really sorry.
Well, if you're sorry, just leave me alone, okay? I'm gonna go home because this is too much, and I really don't want to be here. Let this be the last time I see you, and if you dare to try contact me again, I will. And I'm not joking, I will put a restraining order in place. Goodbye, Stevie Jackson. Goodbye forever. See you. Oh, this rain is gross. Detective Carlos, I just met Stevie Jackson. You should know that. And I told him that this is goodbye forever. He set up this dinner in the park and it was quite romantic, but I had no interest in it. I told him to leave me alone, okay? Can we just forget about this whole mess? And can we please get somebody to clean up the town? I'm a laughingstock and I just want it all to go away. Thank you. Bye.
This is an announcement for Baby Angel. Oh. Attention! This is an announcement for Baby Angel.
What's going
Angel.
On?
Congratulations, Baby Angel. You have won a shopping spree free of charge here in our shopping center. 5,000 euro to spend at your leisure in any store. Please come to the reception desk and pick up your voucher. This is a once-in-a-lifetime prize.
Well, that's not weird at all. I mean, first, loads of free donuts, and now a free shopping spree? This is weird! What is going on? But hey, girl can't be a... But hey, girl can't complain. I love shopping. I'm gonna go and pick up my voucher and just do what I gotta do. Slightly weird, but this is the best day ever! Oh boy, I'm so excited. I can't believe that voucher extends to my IKEA. This means I can redecorate my treehouse with the most amazing things. And of course, I got to pick up some extra presents for the people that I love. I am gonna be in the good books. Boy, oh boy! This is so exciting! Shibadi-badi-ba-ba-ba! Oh, I love this place so much. Okay, up the stairs till we find the thing that I'm looking for. I don't even know what I'm looking for.
Yes, I wrote this song for you. I'm Stevie Jackson.
What the?
Baby Angel. Yes, I'm sorry and it's true. 'Cause I miss you. And I miss you more.
miss you more in every way.
It's so
I
beautiful.
Miss you more.
It's so nice. Baby, what a pretty
baby,
song.
Baby, baby angel.
Where's it coming from? Oh, Stevie Jackson, how you break my heart over and over and over. Oh, no, not again. My heart can't take it anymore.
Yes, I wrote this song for you. I'm Stevie Jackson.
Ugh, this song! If I have to hear it one more time, it's just following me around. And I'll tell you what, it's not a welcome sight. I've decided to come out for a walk on this beautiful starry night to take in some fresh air and just clear my mind. It's a whole new year. Which means a whole new baby angel, and I want to take the opportunity to reflect and think back on the year that was, to decide what I want to do with my life, to decide what kind of aspirations I should set. Maybe my goal should be to eat more ice cream, tea, perhaps a New Year's resolution can be to hang out more with Baby Max and kiss his cutie pie face a little more often. Another surprise, I don't know why I said that. Another resolution should be to, I don't know, save more people's lives. Like, I mean, this street is so empty, there's probably trouble lurking just around the corner. but yeah, maybe I won't go looking for trouble right now. I mean, it is getting late, and if I don't return past a certain hour, Ruppo will certainly get mad. I mean, I borrowed the car, and I don't even have a full license, and he's just gonna be like, what's my sister doing? Gone for so... Oh my gosh. Is that Coco? What's she doing here? Oh my gosh. She with Baby Angel. What is she doing here with Stevie Jackson? This is so weird. I kind of don't want to look, but I kind of want to look, and I don't want to look, and I do want to look, and I don't. I'll just inch my way forward and see if I can hear anything. If only my supersonic hearing was working. Oh man, I don't want to risk it. I just got a little bit closer. And oh my gosh, what? This is so weird. How do they know each other? Oh, Stevie might see me. Oh man, what is going on? This could be one big mess. All right. Curveball. What? All right, I'll just hide here and hope that nobody sees me. Awkward. I mean, what could they be talking about for so... Oh. Hey, Coco!
Hey, baby. Oh, sorry. I mean, baby angel. It's good to see you, I think. What are you doing hiding in a corner in the park late at night? I mean, it's good to see you, but you are acting a little bit strange, no?
It's really good to see you, too! what's going down? What brings you here?
Oh, you know, this and that, that and this. Life is to be enjoyed, so I'm out enjoying life.
All right, well, I'm here for, go. For a nighttime stroll, to clear my head and to just take in the beautiful stars. Look how many there are. They're so beautiful and twinkly. And just, what? And to just, just enjoy some fresh air, away from my treehouse and, the usual surround. What are you doing in the park? What are you doing here with Stevie Jackson? I saw you! I was going to pretend that I saw nothing, but all I can hear from you is lies, and then I look over there and he's gone, and I just need to know, what is Stevie Jackson doing here with you? Because, I just don't understand, and I don't like it, and, Coco, explain yourself, or I will tell Robo everything that I've just seen, and he's not going to like it. Oh, look, the rain has started. It just means that things are about to get really dramatic. So tell me, what were you doing talking to that loser?
Oh, Angel, are you feeling all right? I wasn't talking to anyone. I think your eyes must be deceiving you. I'm just out having a little walk by myself, and I do not know what loser you're talking about. I'm sorry. Maybe you should go to bed, you little baby. Go home.
Go home? Oh, you were just so nasty, and you are obviously a big liar, too. I saw you standing here, and I saw Stevie Jackson standing there, and I know that you were talking about something, and you were here together before the rain started, when I was hiding here in the corner, pretending that I wasn't even here, and then you came and found me, and you're just a nasty piece of work, Coco, and I never liked you. I never liked you. There, I said it. When you were dating my brother, I hated every piece of you, because you came across as trouble, and I just knew it. I just knew you weren't a good person, like I know now that you are doing something dodgy and fishy, and you need to tell me what it is, or I'm going to go to the cops. And if you don't, oh, forget it. Never mind. Why am I here wasting my time? Go up to my treehouse and chill out and do absolutely nothing. Is that phone ringing? I've never seen that phone before. Yellow Baby Angel speaking!
Oh, hi Baby Angel, it's Coco. I was hoping I would find you. I can still remember Roper's number very well at the top of my head. I was wondering if you would meet me. There is something I would like to talk to you about. I've been thinking, and I should have told you in person, but now I'm calling you to rectify.
Okay. Right, this is interesting. Okay, you know what, Coco? Stuff it. I don't want to know. I don't want to know anything. I'm just going to hang up on you. I'm going to put the phone down. Bye, bye, bye. Ugh. That girl does not know when to stop. Yes, 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 I can hear you ringing. I'm coming. Oh, there it is. They've already hung up. Oh, there's a text message. Let me read it. Oh, it's from Stevie Jackson. Hey, Baby Angel, I would really like you to meet me before you meet Coco. What? Please, give me another chance. We need to talk. Oh, holy moly. Well, this is certainly bizarre. What in the world? What could that mean? Talk to me before you talk to Coco. I mean, what? Okay, here goes nothing. creaky. Oh, hi, Coco. Thanks for inviting me here. Why here? What's going on?
Wow, Angel, I'm surprised you've actually made it. I was certain you would turn me down. I mean, things have been very, very turbulent between us. I know you never really liked me, but I promise you can trust me. I am here to tell you something that I feel you need to know. It's for your own good that I tell you, even though I really don't want to be the bearer of bad news. Where do I begin?
You could begin at the beginning, I suppose. What's going on, Coco? Should I be worried?
Angel, it's not good news. You're not going to like it. Tell you what, go and close the gate. I don't want anyone seeing us here together. And then I will tell you everything there is to know.
The gate? Okay. Strange request. Okay. All right.
right, Coco, spill your guts. What is there to say that you had to bring me to this secret location in the middle of nowhere and into a spooky, creepy graveyard? To be honest, I'm a little bit fearful for my safety because, well, you know, can you blame me? Please tell me what is there that you want to tell me. It's important that I know, and I'm just so curious right now.
Well, Angel, trust me when I say this is not easy for me to tell you. I have suffered a lot of heartache myself in this situation. You see, I lied the other day. I do know Stevie Jackson. I know him really, really well. You must trust in me when I say that he is bad news. He is out to harm you. He is out to get your blood. Baby Angel, Stevie Jackson is a rock star, yes, but he has a criminal past, and your safety is in jeopardy. You are in trouble.
My safety is in jeopardy? What does that even mean? It doesn't even make sense. How could I possibly be in trouble with Steve? He's just a kid like me. He just happens to be really well known. And is there more to the story? Can you please explain what you mean?
Of course, Angel. There's lots to the story. Come with me. I will show you what I mean. And maybe you will understand.
Coco, you're scaring me. You brought me to a graveyard, and now you say there's something you want to show me, and it's got to do with Stevie Jackson? I did not like the sound of this, but okay, if there's something I need to know, then show me, please.
Baby Angel, remember, this is not easy for me. Come on, follow me.
Wait up, Coco. Coco, where did you go? What? A tombstone? Coco? What's going on? Please, explain what's happening here. This is... Who's Poppy? 2015 to 2017? Is this a baby's grave? She died at age 2? Coco, what's happening? Please, help me make sense of this situation.
Baby Angel, I don't know how to tell you, but... Poppy was my younger sister. She dated Stevie Jackson just like you did for a couple of months. He became obsessed with her. But she didn't want anything to do with him. So he kidnapped her. And he killed her. The police found her body. I can assure you it was the saddest day of my life. Baby Angel, I'm here to look after you.
What? Poppy was your sister? Stevie Jackson's a murderer? Why was he not in jail? I mean, what? What's going on, Coco? Are you sure you're telling me the truth?
Baby Angel, how come you can doubt me in a moment of sadness for me? My heart is clearly broken. Stevie Jackson has killed my baby sister. And you are next. Stay well away from him. Rumor has it, he is cursed by a witch. Please, baby Angel. I would hate for something bad to happen to Robo's little sister. The world needs a baby superhero like you. I can protect you. Please let me protect you.
Protect me, Coco? How can you possibly protect me? I mean, the only person that can protect me is myself. This is such bad news. My head is in a spin, and I don't know what to do. Coco, I need to go home and think about all of this. Stevie Jackson, why did you want to talk to me? What's happening?
Baby Angel, thank you for meeting me at such short notice. It really means a lot. I gotta get something off my chest. I know you saw me and Coco talking in the park.
Well, yeah, of course I did. I mean, you guys were in such a public place. If it was a private conversation, maybe you should have... I should have gone somewhere a little more, private. Chef, please, I've asked you already. Can you please... Thank you. You know what I mean? So what's the deal? What is up with you and Coco?
I mean, this is gonna come as quite a shock to you, but believe me, it's true. And I know it might sound crazy, but believe me, it's true. Coco is not who she appears to be.
What? Coco is not who she appears to be? That is so... I mean, that makes no sense. Stevie, what are you talking about?
Coco is actually evil little Kelly. Evil little Kelly is pretending to be Coco.
Chef, for the last time, leave me and Stevie alone. We have really important stuff to talk about. Come on. Why are you being like this? I know you're a huge fan of him, but like, seriously, Chef. Come on, please. Just vacate the room for one moment. Actually, I have a better idea. Stevie, follow me. Come on. We need to find a private area to talk. This is important. Did you just say that Coco is evil little Kelly? Like, what? All right, we should be able to talk in peace here. Can you please repeat what you said to me? I just want to make sure that my ears aren't playing tricks on me. What is it about Coco again?
Coco is not who she appears to be. Coco is actually evil little Kelly. Evil little Kelly is pretending to be Coco. Just please stay away from Coco. Or should I say, evil little
Kelly. Wait. What? Evil little Kelly is pretending... Why would she be pretending to be Coco? I mean, what's the agenda?
Baby Angel, you know, evil little Kelly has been plotting to kill you ever since you were born. You gotta be careful. Stay away from Coco.
Oh man, I need a donut. This is too much. So you're telling me that Coco is actually an imposter, or that evil little Kelly is inside of her and she's trying to, what, like, gain my trust so that she can, what, like, kill me or something? Stevie Jackson, this seems a little bit surreal, and I don't know why I should believe you. I mean, you've been following me around everywhere and torturing me and making my life hell, and people are talking, and now you're telling me that Coco is evil little Kelly. I don't even never see Coco. I mean, for the first time that I saw her was just the other day when I saw her with you. I mean, how am I supposed to know you two aren't plotting something seriously mean against me? Huh?
That's why I've been following you everywhere, baby angel. I am your guardian. My music is your guardian. Ever since I found out the dark secret, I've made it my mission to protect you, baby angel.
Protect me like my guard? Like, why? Your music is my guardian. So I'm still very, very confused. Stevie Jackson, this is bizarre. I'm not gonna lie, this is the most bizarre thing I've ever heard. But it's sweet, I'll admit. I mean, no one really has done something like that for me. Thank you.
There's a lot more to this story, but I'll tell you another day. You know enough for now. Just stay away from Coco. Stay away from Coco. She's not who she seems to be.
Oh, don't worry. It's not like we're best friends or anything. I mean, the only time I really saw her was just with you in the park, and then that started the communication again, but I never liked her, and... Oh my gosh, does that mean my brother was dating evil little Kelly? What? This is all so messed up. Stevie Jackson, speaking of Robo, he's due home really soon. I want to hear what else there is left to this story, but you said that that's enough for now, so you're obviously not going to tell me. Do you mind if you leave?
Yeah.
seems... What is that noise? Oh my gosh. Is there someone downstairs? Hello? Hello? Where's the baseball bat? Quick! I have to find one. I have to find the baseball bat. What if they can hear me? I have to be quiet. I have to be quiet. Baseball bat, yes. There's one. Okay, I gotta sneak downstairs. I see who it is. There's definitely someone out there. Oh my gosh. This is... Get out of my home! Get out! Imposter! Oh, man. Get out of my home! Who are you? What are you doing here? Get out! What are you? I'm gonna hit you with my baseball bat if you don't answer some questions right now! What are you? And who are you? And what are you doing in my home? Stop running away! I'm so scared! Please, 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 answer my questions! Hello, Baby Angel! Hello?
Baby Angel, do not be afraid of me. I am also an angel, sent to you from heaven. No! Do not scream! It's okay! I'm here to tell you something that you really need to know.
What? What is it?
I know that you met Coco. I know everything she told you.
What?
And I know that you met Stevie Jackson.
I did.
And I know he told you everything too.
Uh-huh.
I know you were confused, Baby Angel. I am here to help you. I am here to settle your mind. My name... it's Poppy. No! Baby Angel, please do not scream.
Oh, everything hurts.
Baby Angel, are you okay?
I forgot you were here.
You collapsed.
I thought it was all an awful dream.
You don't have to worry. I am a good angel. I am not here to harm you. I am here to tell you the truth. Something that you deserve to know. The truth is always hard to hear. But trust me, I have no reason to lie.
Okay, I won't scream. I mean, I've got a baseball bat here, and I know how to use it, but I'm gonna trust you. Please tell me your story. Who are you, and why are you in my room? What do you want from me? What's your name?
My name is Poppy. I am 2 years old. I am an angel sent from heaven. I had one sister. I miss her very much. Her name is Coco.
Coco? So you mean everything Coco said in the graveyard was true? Stevie Jackson's a killer? This is not good. Tell me more. Tell me everything you know, please, please, Poppy. Tell me everything you know.
I know Stevie Jackson very well. Stevie Jackson is my brother. Evil little Kelly killed me.
What? Evil little Kelly did what? Evil little Kelly did what? She killed you? Poppy, that is awful. I'm so sorry.
I was so scared. Do not trust anyone. Evil little Kelly killed me while she was masked as my sister. She gained my trust. Said she was taking me to the cinema. That was it. I never saw life again. Don't trust anyone. I don't know if the girl in the graveyard was evil little Kelly or my real sister. Watch your back, Baby Angel. Don't end up like me.
Wow, Poppy, your life sounds like it was so difficult. Everything that happened. I'm sorry to hear all of this. You're so strong. Thank you for coming to warn me. I promise that I will go with my gut, and I will find the answer. And maybe I can capture evil little Kelly, and maybe I should tell Robo about all of this. What do you think?
Do what your heart tells you to do, Baby Angel. But one thing is for sure. You need to trust Stevie Jackson. He's a very good guy. He's my brother. He's the best brother ever. He always thinks of me. Always remembers me. And sometimes I talk to him and he hears me. Those moments are very special for me. And I'm so happy I could meet you. I wanted you to know the truth because you deserve to know it. And I don't want you to get hurt. Do not trust anyone. Please, be careful and look after yourself. Your brother must be treasured. He will look out for your best interests, just like Stevie did for me. Talk to him. Talk to both of them.
There he is. All right. Stevie! Stevie, hi! Oh, Stevie, I'm so glad that you could be here. I really need to talk to you. I see you were trying to call me. I spotted you when I was inside the house.
Baby Angel, I got here as soon as I could. What's bothering you? What's the problem? I mean, you were so urgent. I'm here now. What's the problem? I must admit, your call came as a big surprise to me, but, you know, I got here as quick as I could.
Okay, this is gonna sound absolutely crazy. I mean, I don't even know where to begin. You see, so after we spoke, I know you told me to stay away from Coco, but actually, I had met her the day before I met you, and I wasn't completely honest, but, it's all very confusing because, well, she told me something that has really messed up my head. She told me that she had a sister called Poppy, and that you killed her. But then, something really strange happened last night. There was a thunderstorm last night, and I was asleep in my bed, and something, just bear with me, Poppy appeared in front of me. She was an angel, and she told me everything. She told me that evil little Kelly killed her, but actually, it was evil little Kelly dressed as Coco. And there's more. She said that Coco was actually her sister. You know? So, my mind is fried. I just need to know the truth. What's happening, Stevie Jackson? What's happening?
This is really weird, Baby Angel. I mean, something just doesn't add up. Yes, I do have a sister called Poppy, but the strange thing is, she's still alive.
Excuse me? What did you just say? Can you repeat what you just said, please? Stevie Jackson, what did you just say? What did you just say?
Yes, I do have a sister called Poppy, but the strange thing is, she's still alive.
What? No. That can't be. You're obviously playing some horrible prank on me. You're obviously joking. You're obviously trying to mess with my head. Stevie, I don't appreciate this, please. Please tell me the truth, Stevie. Please tell me the truth.
Something very, very fishy is going on, Baby Angel. I told you, trust no one.
All right. If she's alive, as you say, then I want to meet her. How can I meet her? Where is she? Where's Poppy? And you better not be messing me around, Stevie Jackson.
Well, Baby Angel, follow me and I'll take you to my sister. She's been unwell for the past few months, but things are looking up and she's been going in and out of consciousness. Some days are worse than others, but as I said, I mean, I think she's awake now, so you'd be able to talk to her and meet her in person. And I don't know, this whole Poppy's ghost thing is creeping me out. It just something strange is going on here, and I don't know what it is, but we have to get to the bottom of it, Baby Angel.
You're right. We do. I think we need to go to the hospital. I want to meet Poppy. Come on. We don't have much time, Stevie. Let's run as fast as we can. Come on. Please. Do this for me. Okay, Stevie Jackson, we're here now. Let's go meet Poppy. I really need to meet her, and I really need to talk to her. Come on. Hi, Doc. I'm looking for Poppy. I'm here with her brother, Stevie Jackson. I want to know what room she's in.
Yes, of course. Stevie, hi. It's good to see you again. If you must know, Poppy is doing very well. And who's this lovely lady by your side?
Oh, hey, Doc. That's Baby Angel. I'm here to introduce her and show her to my sister Poppy.
Well, Stevie and Baby Angel, you look wonderful. Nice to meet you. Stevie, you know the way, so you can just walk right on through and right up there.
Thank you so much, Doctor. Come on, Stevie. Let's go up to meet Poppy. So, right through here, he said. Upstairs. Okay. Oh, man, I'm so nervous. I'm so nervous about this moment. Poppy's meant to be a ghost. So this is gonna be weird. Karen's ward. Natalie's ward. Okay, it must be this one. Karen's ward.
Oh my God, Poppy! Poppy! No!